Check one, two. Check one.
How about now?
Check one, two.
Hello? Damn.
So.
Daryl. Hello.
Check one, two. Check one, two, three, four. Check.
Signal to the screen.
What's that?
We have audio to the screen.
Yeah, I'm checking. I'm checking the quality on this.
It sounds good.
Where's the aux hour on this? We're at like 5 and 6.
For score, and as Jacob says, 65 years ago.
Okay, give me a break.
Check one, two. Check one, two.
We are on the age of a new frontier.
Check one, two. Check one, two.
Hello. Yeah. Hello?
Yes, I can hear it. If we can get just a tiny bit more volume.
Hello?
That'll be good. Check one, two.
Hello? Checking one, two, three. Check, check. Check one, two, three. Check, check. Yeah, it's very metallic over here when I talk through here.
Yep.
Hello?
So.
Hello, sunshine.
How about here? Check one, two. Check one, two. Somebody get a switch to a close up on me so that I can see the sink.
Hello, sunshine.
Check one. Check two. Check one, check two, check one, check two. Check one, check two, check one. Not that, I need to see my mouth, not my belly. I know what my belly looks like. I don't even have to bend down to see it. Check one, two, check. Check. Audio's a little ahead of the video.
A little ahead of the video? All right, I'll try and mess with it.
Hello.
Yes.
Testing, one, two, three. Check, check.
La, 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 la. Check, one, two, three. Check, one, two, three.
Is it good over here? Is it good over here?
Check one. Check one, two. Check one, two.
For some reason, this is raised up a little bit.
Check one, two.
Hey, CJ. All right, here.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Check one. Check two.
Is it in sync? Are we in sync?
The other's about half a second behind.
I think Gabe
that horn's broken, okay?
Yeah, crazy.
Check, check, 1, 2, 3. Nothing? It's not doing anything different on the switcher? Check, check, 1, 2, check, check, 1, 2, 3, check, check.
Oh, I swear, you actually got this.
Keep going. Check, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2. Check, two, check, three. Check, check, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Now that we've screwed the rest.
What?
Now that we've screwed the rest.
It was on what? Post, it was on post fader, wasn't it?
I just texted you. I didn't know you. I thought you'd be up here. I brought it up.
Yeah, I love that.
I remember. When I saw you in the office, I thought you'd forgotten. I brought it up for you.
Thank you.
I think it rolled. I think I rolled.
You.
Check, 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 1, 2.
Because now that we're going back to
Justin here yet?
I found the CJ.
Is Justin here yet?
Thank you.
minutes long, so we'll have you out and about as quickly as possible. So hope you enjoy your evening. Please be sure to eat a lot of snacks when you're done, because the more you eat, the less we have to take home. So hope you enjoy the show. Without further ado, here we have the kidnapping of Santa Claus. Places.
Does Santa really live in the North Pole?
Yes, son, he does.
But the North Pole's a big place. What's his address?
He doesn't have an address.
But his letters, where do they go?
They get there. Santa lives in Laughing Valley.
I know Laughing Valley. I saw it on a map.
There, in Laughing Valley, in a rambling castle in which his toys are manufactured. His elves live with him, and everybody is as busy as they can be from one year's end to the other.
On one side is a forest of Rosy, on the other is a cave of disgruntled elves.
Disgruntled?
Yes, it means they are displeased working for Santa. Most say Santa has happy workers, elves who do good deeds and are merry, but several of his elves went on strike, and they formed a union.
Santa doesn't have any enemies.
You would think so, but there was a time. The caves of the disgruntled elves are five in number. A broad pathway leads to the first cave, which is finely arched at the foot of a mountain. The entrance is beautifully carved and decorated. In the cave resides the elf of selfishness. The elf of hatred lives next door, with the elf of greed nearby. Situated deep in the mountain, in a dark and fearful cave, rests the elf of malice. Terrible pitfalls that lead to death and destruction mark the paths between these caves. However, there is a small tunnel in the mountain that leads to a cozy fifth cave, a room occupied by the elf of repentance. He is a pleasant sort of fellow who gladly opens a small door to admit fresh air and sunshine. He takes in those who are sorry that they followed selfish greed, hatred, or malice. Disliking Santa Claus, these disgruntled elves one day held a meeting.
Let's call this reporter. It has been made clear that many of us have a problem with this Santa Claus fellow and his actions.
I really am getting to be lonely. Santa distributes so many great gifts to all the children that they become happy and generous. Because of his example, no one comes to my cave anymore. No one is selfish anymore.
Mm-hmm. I'm having the same problem. These kids seem so content with this Santa Claus. There are, of course, a few I can persuade to be greedy, but not many. These kids are too good.
That makes it bad for me. If no one goes to the cave of selfishness or greed, no one will get to my cave. No one will ever practice hatred.
Or to mine. Kids don't even know what malice means any longer.
For my part, it is easy to see when the kids don't show up to your caves. Without hatred, malice, selfishness, and greed, there is no need to repent. I am as neglected as each of you.
Yeah, and it's all because of this person they call Santa Claus.
He's ruining our business and something has to be done.
Mm-hmm.
I said we take action.
But what can we do? Santa's so full of goodness and mirth that he sees no need for our vices.
Selfishness, you have a way with words. Why don't you go talk to him?
And what will I say? Oh, please give up on Christmas.
That might work.
No, it's too easy. We must have a plan.
Come here.
Break!
It's been decided. Selfishness, you shall visit Santa.
Good luck. We're all counting.
Until Christmas, much to be done, much to be done.
Dear, you're working late again. The doctor says you need to begin resting up soon. Christmas only a week away, you must save your strength.
No time to rest, no time at all. I've got plenty of lists to check, review, go over.
But you get so tired these days. Your vacation wasn't pleasant this summer. What with all the text messages you had to answer, the internet to keep up with, and Facebook, my what a year.
Ah, yes. 7 million friends, 32,000 likes. I've had a good year. Now, I've got to ask you really quickly about the...
Who could that be at a time?
Well, I thank you. My elves have worked extra hard.
They have indeed. Why don't you keep them for yourself?
Pardon me?
The toys. All those pretty, lovely, fun toys. You work so hard making them each year, and it's such a pity for you to give them away to girls and boys who are noisy boys and frightful girls.
Nonsense!
All they do is break and destroy their toys anyway.
The children are never noisy, nor frightful. And if I can make them happy for even just one day of the year, then my job will have been successfully done.
Really? So naive. I have failed. Santa's not at all selfish.
Let me have him. I'll make him safe.
Good luck. We're all counting on you.
Another visitor! Did my wife even try to stop you?
She was quite busy, I messed myself in.
Say, weren't you an elf once?
No, you must be thinking of someone else.
No, I'm quite sure I...
Not me! Now, how about these toys, sir?
Back off! They are for the children.
I don't want them, I wish to buy them.
Nope! Go buy your own. I only give toys to children, and you are obviously not a child.
You know, there are many toy stores that make toys that are just as good as yours. In fact, there's a toy store in Chicago that makes cars that are just as fast and dolls that are just as pretty.
It is an ancient art. What I do is craft.
Why, even in China, they make...
Ah, cease! Don't even go there.
Right, I apologize. But the stores sell theirs for money, sir. Think of what you could do with money. You could buy a new sled. Go on a longer vacation. Join the Richard Simmons weight loss program. Get Mrs. Claus whatever she wanted. You could buy her first name for once.
What I do for the goodness of everybody. I would be ashamed to receive compensation for my gifts. I simply give toys to make the children happy. Now be gone. I have much work to be done.
Excursion.
He won't budge. He's too selfless.
Since we're a real stalwart here, we'll have to devise a better plan.
Mm-hmm.
Come with me, I have an idea.
Bad news for you, Santa. What? Can't hear a thing he's saying. Take the thing off. We don't need it now. You were saying?
I said unleash me!
Oh, well, about this bad news?
Bad news is something that should be kept private and not shared with anyone.
Oh, please don't make me laugh. Stop! This is not funny!
Enough! No more tricks from you. Listen, in this world there are many people, children included, who do not believe in you. In the end, they will come to hate you because you have lied to them all these many years.
Nonsense!
The others resent you make children so happy. They sneer at you
and call you a foolish old rattle pack.
Well, I... A what?
Rattle pack.
You made that word up.
I did not.
I've never heard of it, and neither have they, have you guys?
You definitely
no, you made it up.
That's enough out of you.
It means an old man. A silly man. A pathetic man.
Well, it's not very nice.
I'm not very nice! I'm the elf of hatred.
But I don't hate anybody. I'm only full of goodness and mirth.
What about that boy who kicked you while having his picture taken?
Or the girl who pulled your beard? They are just children. They didn't mean any harm.
You're missing the point. You have to be revenge for these deeds.
But I don't hate them. I don't wish to cause them any sort of harm.
You can sue for slander.
Slander?
Yes.
Yeah. People say untruths about you all the time. They set you up for false hopes and goodness and charities. They even make an off-brand Pepsi product about you.
Such people do me no real harm, except make themselves and their children unhappy. Those poor souls. I'd rather help them any day of the week than to sue them or, heaven forbid, injure them.
Foolish souls.
Wait!
Magic, right. I'll be escaping now. Let's try that one again. Release! Escape! Please?
You're done.
You are powerless here, old man.
But it cannot be. It can't be. I have elven magic.
Elven magic?
Let's just say aluminum foil has many unique and diverse properties.
Just like my mom's Thanksgiving dinner, we've covered this cave in every inch of it, every crevice, every part.
Rats! Foiled again! Alright. 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 What is it you want?
Look. It's the future. Next week, Christmas. There go the reindeer off on their quest. They're climbing high into the night sky.
Without you!
And they rise higher and higher.
Way up high.
Oh, they're stalling. They can't maintain energy breathing so high without you. Santa's magic holds them up. Those silly creatures went up without you. Is that? Oh no, they're falling, spiraling toward the earth.
Oh, I can't watch.
Oh, am I kidding? I love it. The carnage.
And there they plummet. Destroyed. Crushed. 10 million toys wrecked and scattered across the globe.
What will the children do now? Empty space beneath the tree? Empty stockings? Empty souls, those children.
Enough of this! What do you people want?
We want you to cancel Christmas.
Cancel Christmas? I cannot!
Listen, people don't care anymore. They only want the gifts, the merchandise.
My good man, ever heard about the gift card? It's a disgrace to the Christmas spirit.
Well, actually, they're quite brilliant. Do you know how much money the banks make off the interest alone?
Shut up!
Well, have you?
Shut up.
All
right. Listen, all the children will receive now is what we can grant them. Greed, hatred, and malice.
We have done a mighty clever thing.
Bye for now, Santa.
A week passed, and suddenly it was Christmas Eve. Santa's top elf, Wisp, was busy checking last details and came to Santa's workshop to go over inventory.
Santa, what do you want me to do with the... Whoa. Where'd the big guy go? Peter? Riley? Kilter? Come quick!
What is it, Whisk?
Santa's missing!
Impossible! Nonsense!
What are you talking about?
His chair is empty!
So?
Have you ever known Santa to leave that chair between Halloween and Christmas Eve?
Now that you mention it, no, not really.
Nope, I've never really seen him elsewhere.
See? Something's up. What should we do?
Let's ask Blitzen.
We can't speak reindeerese. Only Santa can.
I know. Let's ask Mrs. Claus.
No! You know how busy she is. Whisk, are you sure you've looked everywhere?
Yeah, I checked the whole castle. What shall we do?
We must find him. Everyone, put on your thinking caps.
Oh no. Oh no. Ho, 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 Oak. Oh no, guys, there's no Santa. What are we gonna do? What are we gonna do?
We don't have much time. If we delay, there'd be no time to deliver the present for tomorrow morning.
That would grieve Santa more than anything else.
It's certain that there are evil creatures that have captured him.
But why would anyone capture Santa?
Because if they don't, we don't have much of a place, silly.
Oh, yeah. But why?
They must have wanted to make the children unhappy.
And they knew that holding Santa back would allow that to happen! Oh, guys, this is absolutely terrible!
Wait, hold on. Our first priority must be to deliver the presents tonight, as Santa had done it himself.
But we're just elves!
Sprites!
Knaves!
Come on, we can't let Christmas pass. We can do this. Gather your courage and come with me. Whisk, call the reindeer.
On Comet,
on Cupid, on Dasher, on Dancer.
Hey guys, this is the part where we go save Christmas.
Oh!
They were so cute at that age, so they did their best. They gathered the reindeer and dashed over hill and valley, through forest and city, until they had visited every house where children lay sleeping and dreaming of Christmas morning. By dawn they had done it. All gifts had been delivered. They were exhausted, but proud. But there were a few small errors. The elves didn't quite have the judgment Santa does, and they do not understand children very well, so it's no wonder they made some laughable mistakes. Sydney Brown wanted a doll and got a truck. Charlie Jones wanted a guitar and got a sewing box filled with needles and thread. There were other mess-ups, but most brothers and sisters simply exchanged their gifts with each other and thought Santa must have been tired from his long journey to have made such a simple mistake. Had they made many errors, the disgruntled elves would have been successful, but it all worked out well, and on the early rise of Christmas morning, for the first time in history, the reindeer took to their stable just as the sun was peeking out over Laughing Valley. Little did the disgruntled elves know a special secret.
The children are waking now, waking to find empty stockings. Oh, how they will bite and cry and call you a fraud. Use bad words to describe you.
You're nothing but a polytart wart eater.
There you go, making up words again. I'm getting you a dictionary. I will not be grieved. Goodness shall prevail.
Goodness? You're so naive. And that is a real word.
Let's depart. There's work to be done. I'm going to watch the prisoner. You can call him Santa. He does deserve that respect. Not after today. Once Christmas passes without him, Santa will be but a memory. Send in repentance to guard this man.
Repentance! Get over here.
Be silent, will you? Have you come to torture me further?
No.
Then, yes, please, just stay quiet. I don't need anything else.
The other disgruntled elves do not trust me much. They left me out of the planning, and only brought me in now that Christmas Day is breaking. But their mischief is done, and Christmas Eve will be lost forever.
Now, don't be silly. Forever is a long time. What is 1 year?
1 year?
Christmas isn't about the gifts, or the merchandise, or anything like that. It's about hope. curse shall continue with each season, so only then can mankind continue to flourish.
Well, gee. When you put it that way, it doesn't sound all that bad, this Christmas thing. But don't you want to be rich? Sell your toys. Be more famous than your wildest. Oh, wait. You are famous, aren't you?
I am loved, and that is enough. Simply being loved makes all the work worthwhile.
But Christmas Eve is past, and for the first time in centuries, you have not visited the children.
The children will be disappointed, that is for certain.
Oh, that can't be helped now. And if they visit the caves of hatred, malice, selfishness, and greed, I shall try to lead them to the cave of repentance.
But do you never repent yourself?
Oh, yes I do. But it's too late for that. Repentance can only come, though, after an evil thought or deed.
Now that is selfish.
Wait, why do you say that? I'm good.
If repentance can come only after an evil deed, then how do you benefit anything from this? How do you go to... Oh, so it was you who concocted this plan so that children would visit the caves of selfishness, greed, malice, and hatred, so that it may grant you the power that you desire.
Yet you have done no evil. And here you are, sitting in front of my cave. Do you have nothing to repent for?
Well, the one year when the elves were on strike, I did something I regret.
What? A confession? From Santa Claus? Oh, I gotta go get myself a pencil and paper.
There's no reason for such formality.
Fine. What was your sin?
And it wasn't a sin. Don't be so serious. Well, as I said, the elves weren't working, so I was behind in loading my sleigh, so I had to do something regrettable.
And
I had to hire a UPS to make deliveries to all of Western Canada.
What's your kind of sin?
Then your sin is forgiven as well.
What? No! You can't do that! You must come to me for repentance. I have the absolute power in this ordeal.
Forgiveness is just as important, young man.
What? No, how did you do this?
You really have to ask? It's Christmas magic.
Oh my god, help! Guys, he's loose! Come quickly! Trips and rage! He's coming! Shooting!
Quickly, surround him!
Everybody freeze! Everybody clap your hands. Really, all too easy. Be gone, you workers of ill will. Go back to your caves and dwell in the shadows. Christmas shall continue without you. Goodness shall prevail. Be gone! Now.
Here we come to see Santa!
Open your mouth! Take no prisoner!
Really, boys? You're just elves. You strike no fear. However, I would choose no finer pack to save me in my moments of despair.
But, sir, where are your captors? We'll face them to our death in your good honor.
Oh, I sent them away.
But they had you captured. I saw it happen on that tracking computer. Your powers were gone.
Yes, they were gone, but I used an ancient trick to simply transfer them to you. It would give you the idea to ideally go out and save Christmas.
Something?
Not a Jedi, kid. Better. A saint! Although, I have been told I've got a passing similarity to Liam Neeson. Anyway, it was thanks to your boys' bravery that you saved Christmas. The disgruntled elves still think Christmas was ruined, for I cast upon them a vision of sad and terrible times. So I sent them away afterwards. They're gone now. Ideally,
captor, sir. We must pursue them, and justice must be served.
Yes, let's get them.
On guard!
Toro! Toro!
To arms!
Boys, 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 you aren't even real, let alone soldiers. It is useless to pursue. pursue the disgruntled elves, for they will always have their place in the world. Malice, hatred, and greed shall always persist, but only through acts of goodness can they be sent away forever. Now, let's head back to the castle. I hear Mrs. Claus has a feast planned.
Goodness, I'm starving.
Oops.
Oh, well, I'm sure there's going to be plenty more for that.
Well, we really did well, didn't we, Santa?
Yes, you did.
And we were brave. We had no idea you transferred your magic to us, so our deeds were legit, right?
Straight down. Street cred, my man.
Huh?
Never mind. It was in your thinking caps. I simply transferred my magic to them to give you guys the idea to save Christmas.
You know, you should take better consideration and not get captured. We might not be so fortunate next time.
Right, yes, of course. Just be sure to upgrade me to the iPhone X next year. With upgraded GPS and tracking capabilities, you would have found me 24 hours ago.
All right. Shall we?
Yes, let's.
A Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good night. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Have a wonderful holiday.